how to determine fixed end reactions. Support reactions or reactions at a support are generally represented by RE. Reactions are forces that are created at a particular point or at an area where there is some sort of restrainment happening. So when the restrainment is provided using support, the reactions caused as a result of this support is what we call as support reactions. Now, if a support do not restrain the movement at that particular point, there is no sort of reactions happening. That is, there are zero reactions. Now, today in this video, we are going to deal with fixed end support and the reactions associated with it. Now, for this, for convenience, I have considered a cantilever beam AB whose end A is fixed and the end B is free and subjected to an inclined load of P at an inclination of theta. Now, under the action of load P, the deflection pattern followed by a cantilever beam is as shown in the figure. Now, we will concentrate on each end and find out what will be the reactions at the ends. Our first area of focus is end B, where the end B is a free end. Under the action of load P, there is a deflection happening in the beam, but there is no deflection at the point A as the A end is fixed. So here we'll concentrate at end B. We'll see that end B has deflected from a point, say B to B1, at a distance of y, which is the deflection provided. So under action of load P, the end A remains as such, but the end B deflects. Deflection at point B results in a displacement of a value, which is a non-zero value, and this deflection pattern will have a slope corresponding to that deflection, which is given by theta B. So here at point B, there are no sort of reactions as the end is not restrained. The end is free to move. So the support reactions at B is given by zero. So this is a simple concept, right? There is no kind of force or any kind of support that restrains the support B. So thus there is no restrainment, there is no reaction. Now we will consider the end A. When you consider the end A, you see it is fixed. So the fixed end A restricts the movement of end B. When you look into the XYZ direction, you can see the fixed end will restrain the movement of that particular point along X direction, along Y direction, and along Z direction. So, as a result of which, the displacement along X direction is actually zero. There is no kind of movement happening. So delta X is equal to zero. Displacement along Y direction, it is not moving up and down. So the displacement along Y axis is delta Y equal to zero. Now, there is no kind of deflection happening at A as like B. So there is no slope of theta A equal to zero. So there is no X value, there is no Y value, and there is no slope. So the slope value, it means that along Z direction, there is no rotation happening at the point A. There is no rotation in the sense the rotational movement is also restrained. At A, horizontal, vertical, and rotational movement at A is restricted by the fixed end support. Movement is restrained means it leads to certain reactions at A. So those reactions will be a rotational movement that is given by the bending moment. Here, the rotational movement, restrained rotational moment is given by the bending moment M. The direction, X direction moment is restrained as a result of which a reaction along X direction is originated, which is Rx. The moment along Y direction is restrained and that causes a reaction along Y axis, that is Ry, and hence there are three reactions, support reactions at end A. So support reaction at fixed end A is Re, which is given by Rx, Ry, and M. So there are total of three numbers of support reactions at A. So this is how we derive the support external support reactions at a particular fixed end. So these are called as external support reactions, which will be later taken into consideration while determining the indeterminacy of structure. Hope this video was helpful for you in understanding the support reactions originated in a fixed event. For more informative videos, kindly subscribe to our channel, Engineering Fanatics.